Well, hi folks, in this video I'm gonna show you how to connect your phone to your TV, or rather we can say how to screen mirror your phone to your TV. So the TV that I'm using in this video is a Sony Bravia 48 inch TV. It's not a smart TV, but it supports Wi-Fi. And the phone that I'm using to screen mirror is an Asus Zenphone 5. So now let's look at a step-by-step tutorial on how to screen mirror your phone to your TV. The first step would be take your remote, hit the home button, and go to settings, system settings, go to setup, click on the Wi-Fi setup. You make sure that you switch on the built-in Wi-Fi as well as Wi-Fi Direct, and the moment you switch on your Wi-Fi Direct, you will get a Wi-Fi Direct setting. So get into that, hit the option button and click on manual. So, and then click on other method. Now what your TV does is it offers you a WPA key. Now the next step is you take your smartphone, you go to settings, switch on the Wi-Fi. Now your phone shows your TV's network. In my case, it's showing me direct PR Bravia. So I get into that, and now my phone is asking for a WPA key. So from my TV, I take the WPA key, that is XEK capital Y 8733, and hit connect. So now my TV is showing me, are you sure you want to register the following device? And what I do is I accept it. And once you do that, your TV shows that it's connected with one device. Now you just have to get out of this. You just have to hit the return button and totally get out of this setting. And then on your phone, go to setting, go to Wi-Fi, and just forget the network. Well, you would wonder, like, you know, why did I connect my device if I actually had to forget it? Like, this is the only way to pair your device to your TV or get it registered to your TV. And then go to the screen mirroring option through your remote. Now on your phone, in an Asus Zenfone 5, you get a setting known as Plate 2. So you click on the following setting, and now it's showing me the model number of my TV. Okay, so I hit on this setting and it shows me connecting to KLV device, and my TV is asking me to accept the device. And once I accept my device, it takes a while. And after so much of struggle, you finally can mirror your screen with your TV. But then once you get it all paired, then the next time connecting it to your TV, it's pretty simple. And the best part about this is that there's hardly any lag, maybe a millisecond lag. It almost works in real time.